Right, I've just had this come through post. It's for one of my other projects. It's a two-channel receiver. It's going to go in a big, bigger, bivy power pack I'm making. But it's like all else. It's a slow process. So I'll just take you through what I've got. When it first come, it was configured non-latching. So as soon as you press the button and released it, the relay dropped out. Now that were an easy fix. If you look the wet screwdriver is, there's three solder points. There's one, two and three. Now it was soldered between two and three when I first got the device. So I just unsoldered that, cleaned it off and then just put a solder blob between one and two. That made the relays latching. On the board, we've got LAN relay one, LAN relay two. So if you want to add extra remotes, you can do, or if you want to program one button to do both relays, you can do, or if you've got any of these remotes kicking about. I'll show you how I've currently got it wired and the pins. So here I've got plus 12 volts, then O volts. Then another O volts out, common, normally open, another O volts, a common, and another normally open. So that's relay one and relay two, or either which way around you program it. One's A, one's B. So basically, if you just come from these two pins there to your center pin and the top pin of the switch on your bivvy, you want to override wirelessly. It's quite a quick fix. So as soon as you press it, there you go, you've got multimeters. Put in the dead short. Well, my battery's going flat, so it's not that good. So there you go. You got little indicating relay LEDs to let you know channels activated. So yeah, I don't know if it's going to be any use to you. I would suggest though using thicker cable if you've used thicker cable on your bivvy. This is just a test. Don't want to be drawing too much on these alarm cables, and also I put it on its own switch if you can do. Just saves any feedback issues or out like that. It just makes it function correctly. Overall, I don't think it were too bad. I think it will just less than a fiver, and it's quite versatile. You can either use it for latching your lights on and off, or you could use it as a garage controller, I suppose. If you lose your fob, you could add it to a garage roller door and just get it to trigger. Anyway, I hope this video was of some use.